What's up, guys? So I'm gonna talk a bit about the latest patch. Tell you what I think about what I'm seeing from the community so far, because I can't tell you what I think of the patch from personal experience, because I haven't tried it and I don't plan to try it. I uninstalled the game months ago, and there isn't anything here that's gonna get me to reinstall the game and try it, because the things that I find that are fundamentally broken about this game aren't being addressed with this patch, and isn't gonna change my experience. There's no need for me to do it. But I'm just letting you guys know, full disclosure, that I'm personally not, I can't tell you from personal experience what this patch is doing. But I have watched other people's videos. Several videos are up from different guys in the community. And I'm going to look at the Traxian article discussing the patch, because I really want to focus more on what's the more important aspects of the state of everything that you know, with this game and the company. I haven't seen anything in any of the footage that stands out to me like, oh wow, look, this is a big difference. Something changed. Even the people that have tried the patch, some of them have been, you could tell they're trying to find something good to say, but you know, others have just said, hey, you know, there's still issues with the game. There's still bugs that are present in the game. And one person in particular, which I don't want to start pointing fingers, and I certainly don't want to go back into, you know, I said everything I need to say concerning, you know, certain people in the community. But, you know, at one point, he made some good points, by the way, in the video. I'm sure you guys who follow this will know what I'm talking about. But one point that he made that I totally agree with is that the game is locked at 30 frames on the next-gen consoles. So they made sure to go to 4K, but it's locked at 30. I couldn't agree more. That's a disaster. I'll talk more about that as I go further into the article about the patch. But then he turns around later in the video, and this just doesn't surprise me anymore. But he just had to make a small defense of Motorsport Games and like, oh, you can't say they're not trying. This is like 11 or 12 patches. So we got almost a dozen patches out. And he's like, you know, they're working hard. They're trying. They're, you know, you can't say they're not, you know. So that kind of shit it's cringe to me. But I don't care if they issue 1,000 patches. If the patches don't do anything to substantially improve the game, who cares? I mean, this is months later, and to me, they didn't really do much. Some of the things they did in there, I will say, are slightly positive if they work, but it's 8 months after the release of the game. And we're almost at a dozen patches, and the game is not that much improved. So I don't care if you issue 1,000 patches. I'm not going to give you credit for that. But this is where we are, where people in the community, they still want to, like, oh, you know, they're trying. And unfortunately, this is common business practice in the industry now. How many times have you seen games that are released and then a year later they're like, wow, this game really is, it's finally worth playing and it's finally, you know, pretty decent. And people give it credit and they're like, wow, the developer never gave up and they kept issuing patches. Well, they're supposed to. You released a pile of shit, you charge money for it, You're damn right I expect you to keep working on it. And to expect people to own a broken or shitty fucking product and just take the crumbs that you give them through patches and then being happy with the marginally improved aspects of the game, it's a joke. And that kind of shit is like, I don't get it, but some people will never learn. But that's neither here nor there, whatever. So I'm going to read the article and then I'll tell you what I think as I go along. Again, I did not try it. I uninstalled this game months ago. I'm not going to reinstall this fucking game just to see if, the HUD is better or, you know, the wheel support for Fanatec, which is finally instituted. Does it work? Is it different? It's not going to make a difference to me because none of these things address the major issues with this game, which is fundamental things like the AI, which is still an abomination. And I don't care who you are. Any racing game, to me, always at the top of the list is AI. I've been saying this for many years. Those of you who've been watching my videos, this is not new to you. And if anything, you know, this game has proven my point that it can look good visually. The physics, I suppose, are somewhat better, but it's hard to tell because the handling is still something that's terrible. The car is mostly tight everywhere you go. And the presets, they just didn't do enough to make each preset really different from one another where you can make that simple change and then feel a dramatic difference. So how do you really know how good the physics are if the handling is something that you're kind of in a box? So it's tough to say. But, you know, according to some people, it's like, hey, the physics are better than what we had in the Heat series. So I'm not going to argue that point. But it just goes to show you that the AI being so bad, this game is a chore to play. I never once had a good time with it. It just feels like I should be paid money to be playing the game. That's how bad it is. And I've seen some of the videos of this new patch. I don't see a big difference. Now, some people are saying, whoa, yeah, it does look better. It's 4K, but it's locked at 30 frames. This is a racing game. And the thing that gets me more than anything, it's one thing to say that the game has issues that can be fixed, right? If you want to say that. I'm not saying it. I'm just saying if you want to buy into what other people are saying, the point for me is the focus of this developer or the people in charge of making the decisions on what are we going to do to make changes to this, to make it a better experience. They're not even making the right decisions, in my opinion. For instance, this 4K 30 cap for these next-gen consoles. First of all, these next-gen consoles are very powerful. They are at least comparable to a mid-range PC. I'm not saying they're like having an ultra fucking gaming PC, but they are at least capable of what mid-range PCs can do. And we've seen other games. Have you seen the latest Forza videos for the game that's coming? And that game is pushing ray tracing, 4K, I'm only going by the videos that have been released, but it's all gameplay footage. It's not fucking cutscenes and shit like that. And you have a NASCAR game that's locked at 30 frames on next-gen consoles. That's a terrible decision. And that's a conscious decision that was made by certain people. Which just goes to show how disconnected you are. And do you even care about your job? Like, as a director of game development, whoever it is, that like, wow, how into this are you? Is this just a job? I mean, anybody that's into this would know the importance of the frame rate. 4K, the difference between 4K and let's say 1440p is not that much. You really have to sit there with a magnifying glass to notice these differences. It's not worth it. If the decision to me, it would be, okay, stick with 1440p and give people 60 frames. This is a racing game. So if you're making those type of decisions just on that end, how can anybody have any hope for the future? What are they going to produce in 2023 if they're still around? Okay? So this is why I don't see how anyone can have any hope or any positive outlook on where they're going when they're already showing you they don't know what they're doing. That's a terrible decision. And even people who are used to carrying water for this company are telling you that's an awful decision. So let's look at this article. Traxion, who is under the Motorsport Games umbrella, and to their credit, they do disclose that at the end of the article, because some people don't really know that. So let's see. PS5, Xbox Series versions are now available, blah, blah, blah. Free upgrade to existing owners, quicker loading times, crisper visuals, but still 30 frames. So kudos to them, right? Even though they are a subsidiary of Motorsport Games or Motorsports, Motorsports, the fucking parent company, whatever. They still point out that it's locked at 30 frames still. So they do a better job than you would expect, just being upfront. But I mean, at this point, they probably know we can't bullshit people, and nobody's gonna take us seriously if we just keep trying to push a positive spin. Enhanced resolution but not frame rate. What that boils down to is native 4K on PS5 and Xbox Series X and upscaled 4K for Xbox Series S. The existing PS4, blah blah, were not able to hit higher visual fidelity levels. The difference is noticeable with crisper vehicle and delivery detailing. Even your crew chief looks marginally clearer. That is where I think they're bullshitting a little bit. You really do have to have a magnifying glass. I don't believe that it looks that much better. And some people have said it. Others people have said, yeah, it does look better. I've seen videos where people say that there are artifacts in even in the gameplay where it's like it's 4K, but you could see some fuzzy detail whether it's the character model or the crew chief or whatever. So it's like, people need to understand that you can make something 4K, but if it could be 4K of having bad artifacts in the image. So who cares if it's in crisp 4K if you're what you're looking at is has flaws in it. And the trade-off with the 60 frames, it's just not worth it. And anybody who makes a racing game should know that. And most racing games can easily hit 60 frames on these next-gen consoles. I don't understand. How many people are still working on this game? How much money is still being poured into it? That's a mystery to me. You know, we all heard about how much they were investing before the game was released, and you make these assumptions that wow, it's gonna be great, but you don't really know where all this money's going, and the decisions being made, I've always said this, are more important than anything. So if you have people at the top who are saying, yeah, let's make this 4K even though it's gonna cap us at 30, that's a terrible decision. You shouldn't be in charge of this. I don't get it, but I'm not surprised. Sadly, there doesn't appear to be a similar bump in frame rates. Okay, so yeah, they're at least pointing that out. 30 frames performance is underwhelming when the majority of major racing titles on these contemporary machines manage at least 60. Kudos to Traxion for pointing that out. They could have left that out. You know, they did already state that, you know, the frame rate isn't there. But they mention it again. And they remind you that most racing games on these consoles manage to hit 60 frames. So I have to give them some credit. Kudos to them for that. One thing not in the change log that we've noticed is rapidly quicker loading times. I'm all for that. That's a nice little positive. Starting a single race at Road America in last gen took over 30 seconds. That's now down to just over 11 seconds. Yeah, that's a big difference. And I, for one, am someone who looks forward to games that load quicker and not just sitting around staring at a loading screen. So that's a step in the right direction. But really, cross-generational online multiplayer. This is something, if it works, you know, I haven't seen anybody confirm it, but there's such a small pool of players still playing this game that, all right, so you might have had 3 people in a lobby, now you might have 6, if, you know, but this whole idea is something I really hope that more developers push. I don't care what game it is. It doesn't, whether it's a sports game or any game, like Grand Theft Auto, the next game that comes out, I hope is cross-generational. I want to play against, people on the Xbox side. Having those rivalries, also having lobbies with more people, that's always going to be a better thing, and it adds to the experience. This is good if they can make it work, which who knows with these guys if this is going to work, but you know, the intent is good. So not every decision has been bad. This is a good thing. If it works, somebody's going to have to confirm this for me, because I am not playing this game again. I've moved on. I'm strictly on iRacing now. My only interest is on the next NASCAR game. Whether it's someone else or whether it's Motorsport Games, if they're still alive and 2023 is coming, I am interested to see what they are planning to do to get people to say, this isn't going to be the last game. We are making big changes. I'm not saying I believe it. I'm just saying I'm curious to know where they're going, what they're going to tell us. Because they know, they have to know. It's not enough to say we're just going to keep baby stepping improvements to a shitty fucking game like this. So I'm just curious on that end, if they're still around. With this latest update, those racing online can race those on the PS4. And those on an Xbox One can race those on an Xbox Series, but not a PlayStation against Xbox. I'm sorry, I misread this. My mistake. This is what's tricky when you read things. You don't want to make the mistake I just made. I thought it was cross-platform. Cross-generational means PS4 to PS5. So, all right, so I made a mistake there, and I have to take some of that credit back from those guys, because, yeah, it's nice, but you're still within the same platform. I want to see the game developers push where it's cross-platform, where you can play people on other platforms. There's no reason that you can't do it except for corporate interests. But, yeah, cross-general. Okay, so that really takes a lot of steam out of that. Big fucking deal. I mean, could you imagine if PS5 can only play against PS5? I mean, who you're going to play one other guy that's playing this game? Wow. The PS5 version also received accolade support, whatever that means. Following an online race, you can deliver a little rating of sorts to fellow drivers. Either helpful, welcoming, or good sport. All right, so you could tell somebody he's being a douchebag or nice race, whatever. I mean, this is the kind of shit that months of work so this latest patch is giving us. I'm sorry. This just isn't anything to fucking brag about. Save transfers, okay. You can transfer your saves from the old console to the new one. Whoopty fucking do. Make sure you have the latest version, blah, 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 blah. All right, whatever. Here's the thing that I'm... The only thing I'm interested in is, like I said, 2023. The release follows news that there will be no new NASCAR game in 2022, with developer Motorsport Games committing to a new title in 2023, not based on the same technology as Ignition. Several fundamental flaws with the game's AI, timing, and wheel support remain. So, this is where I have big questions. Not based on the same technology as Ignition. Now, I've talked about this before, where they've said things like we're making a change to the game engine, but not the whole game engine. Like, I'm not really sure what they mean by that. I was not aware that you can do that to a current build. Like, if you're going to build a game from scratch and you just want to go with a different engine, that's fine. I didn't know that you can take an existing game and make fundamental changes to the game's engine. Now, they're not based on the same technology. Yeah, you don't really know what they mean by that. But based on other articles and the other things I've talked about in the past, they do refer to the, you know, Unreal Engine. So, one thing I've noticed, and I've seen other people mention it, the Unreal Game Engine. And this is something I've talked about for years, going back to the Heat series. A lot of people were crying and screaming about the Unity Engine. And I told people from the start, be careful. Blaming everything on a game engine, it sounds great. Like, oh wow, if we just get a better game engine, everything's going to magically improve. And I warned people, those of you who do follow me regularly, you know what I'm talking about. And I've told people, a game engine is just provides you the tools on creating a game. Now, yes, there are differences in game engines, and some game engines may produce a better result for what, depending on the game you want. But the Unreal Engine is like the top engine. Everybody's fucking drooling, but it may not be the best engine for a race game. You know, a NASCAR game is very, it's a very linear title. It's not the same as an open world adventure game where you have a million things happening to make the world a living, breathing thing. And now I've seen people say that this thing doesn't really, it's hard to work on. From what I've heard. And I would think that if you're developing a game, to me, NASCAR games are very simple. I'm not saying they're easy to develop, but in terms of the structure, it is simple. It's a linear experience. You're either on the track or off the track. There is no like, oh, open world where you're driving from your house to the racetrack. And, you know, it's, there's a menu. There's a way to, or user interface where you can follow your stats and things like that. And then there's track stuff. And then hopefully if the game's really good, you have a lot of presentation and a narrative. When you look at like Formula One, what they're doing, they deliver all of the things I've talked about for years. If we had a NASCAR game designed the way that Codemasters designed the latest couple of F1 games, man, I would be the happiest guy. It's just, it sucks to see that the F1 community gets to enjoy something like that, and we're stuck with garbage. And these developers know, they've been listening to the community, and they still can't manage to just give people what they're asking for. We're not asking for the moon and the stars. Just follow the formula. of things that already exist. And they can't do it. It's amazing. But what is it that they're going to do? That's my biggest question and what I'm most interested in seeing. Committing to a new title in 2023, not based on the same technology. I didn't know you could really make fundamental changes to the game engine or anything like that. But if anybody out there who knows more about game development understands what's going on, please let everybody in on what all of this means. I'm not an expert on the technical stuff. I'm not an expert on game development. So, yeah, I'm curious. That's the only thing that has my interest. We're not getting a new NASCAR game from anyone else anytime soon. And then I told you guys before. So, this is all we have. And if this company's still around long enough to make a game in 2023, they have a lot of work to do and they have a lot of explaining to do in what they're trying to achieve. And before I go, I want to talk about one other thing. Besides the game engine that everybody was crying about with the Unity, and I told people that is not the biggest issue with the Heat series, and I told people the biggest issues were the decisions made. And one decision that was made by 704 that I completely disagreed with was deciding to add a dirt series. All the work that was put into that, and they put work into it, creating all of these tracks and physics for dirt. And I said, if they would have taken all those resources and just poured it into the career mode, poured it into fleshing out the game that already existed, already had three series, already, and just add presentation and polish everything else up. They already had a decent AI, and that was NASCAR Heat 3. By the time they got to NASCAR Heat 4, in my opinion, is still the best AI we've had in any NASCAR game. Now, the Thunder series was a long time ago, so it's possible that that AI might be better. I'm not sure. But to my memory, you know, the NASCAR Heat 4 AI was really good. It wasn't perfect. It still had issues. But I had a lot of fun racing that AI. And if they could have built on that and put more time and resources into that and polished that and made it even better, worked on the tire model, worked on the pit stops, worked on all that stuff, you could have really had a game that it may not have looked visually as impressive as NASCAR 21, but it would have been a much better, well-rounded game. And we already waited years with the baby steps. And instead of doing that, they decided to add a dirt series that added nothing to the game. I know there's some of you out there that claim that you love the dirt and you had a lot of fun with it. I played it and I couldn't wait to get out of dirt so I can get to the trucks and move ahead. And in the big scheme of things, instead of improving the overall game and making it deeper, more immersive, and adding more to the career mode, and actually improving what was already an impressive AI, they could have done all that. But instead, they decided to go all in on dirt. And now you got four series in the game, and that actually didn't add that much to the game. And had they made the decisions that I said they should have made, and improved all the other areas of the game in the career mode, and continue to improve the AI, and add presentation to the game, and it, so that it feels deeper and more immersive, they could have held on to this franchise, 704. But instead, they added something that was not necessary and did not really add much. And it stagnated the rest of the game. It just, people were like, man, We're 4 or 5 years in, and it's still, we're getting baby steps. And it was back then that I said, this was a mistake. Making that decision to go add dirt, put all that work that they put in, and they did a good job because the tracks of the dirt tracks really had a lot of personality. I thought they looked great. But I don't care about dirt, and I don't think adding a series adds anywhere near as much value as presentation, AI, career mode, ownership. There's so much more they could have focused on. And if they would have, I think 704 would still be making these games, and we would be talking about how much these games have improved through the years, and we would be all on board. In fact, they might have been on the same trajectory as the Formula One series, which took years to get to where they are. It took many years. Instead, they flushed it down the toilet, adding a gimmick series. And I told you guys back then it was a mistake, and I think history has proven me correct. They weren't able to really inject enough life into the series to where people were like, you know what? It took a while, but I can support this. This is actually not bad. Because I can go back to NASCAR Heat 4, and I've actually contemplated picking that game up again, but I don't want to put money into the pockets of Motorsport Games. But I actually had fun with that. And this is why I like I've always said before, the decisions made by the at the top are the most important things, because that dictates everything else. I don't blame the developers who are working on the game. You know, they're doing the best they can, but if they're being told to work on shit that doesn't matter, it's all in vain. So, if you've tried the patch, let me know what you think of it. I just don't see anything here that's going to make a difference. And I couldn't care less about the update that's coming in the fall. Just updating the rosters and paint schemes and whatever else they're doing is not going to make a difference. The only possible thing I have to look forward to, just in terms of interest, is what are these people really planning to do with 2023? I think that a lot of this shit here about not based on the same technology, they've talked about the game engine and making big fundamental changes. They've admitted that the game is hard to work on and it doesn't port well to consoles. So a lot of the limitations are probably based on the game engine, which I told people years ago, you know, it's not all about game engine. The Unity engine, I get it, it's not the best engine, but it wasn't that fucking bad. They were able to make the game look decent. You know, and now we look. It's like you got the best game engine available. And what? What came of it? So, I think I was right. I think. So, I don't know, man. It sucks that you, all your hopes lie with a disastrous company, and they haven't shown anything to this to date. Yeah, they've released 11, 12 patches. Well, I lost track of how many. And you look at the game, it's not really that much better than when it released. Yeah, they got rid of some bugs and glitches and stuff, but It's I don't know. That's all I can really say about it right now. You can tell me, I guess it's fair, that, hey, you didn't play this patch. You don't know if it's really that much better. Fine, that's fair. I can accept that. But I'm not going to reinstall this game just to try it. Because I already know there's nothing in the list that's going to interest me. I don't care about the online racing. I don't. And I've seen footage already. The game looks almost the same. next gen update, and it's like what, 4K? It's not going to be that big of a difference. You know, if you want to take a magnifying glass and stare at the screen, yeah, you might see a difference, but it's nowhere near of a difference as if they would have just left it and pushed 60 frames. You can't make a racing game in 2022 and have it run at 30 frames. That's just unacceptable for anybody. So those are my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think about the patch. Is there anything I'm not aware of that you can school me on? Fine. I'm all ears, but yeah, I have no interest in anything revealed by Motorsport Games until they talk about the next actual 2023, that game, if they're still alive by then. You know, if even whether they die or not, no one else is gonna make a NASCAR game, or release, I should say, release a NASCAR game within 4 or 5 years. Even if somebody stepped in right now, took over the license, and said, "We just broke ground on a new game," you're not gonna see that game for at least 4 years. And this is a game they've been working on since NASCAR Heat 3. So this game already has years of development, and look at what you have. Anyway, those are my thoughts. I look forward to your comments. Later. There's no been a friend to me. You don't want to love me. Don't know what I might do.